There is a new alarming report on AIDS just out today. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention says nearly 3 out of 4 Americans living with HIV do not have their infection under control. The report comes just 2 days before World AIDS Day on Thursday. Joining us to break down this report, senior medical correspondent Elizabeth Cohen. Nice to see you. So there are these great drugs out there, great drugs, as we say, to treat HIV. So why are so many people having a hard time controlling?
I mean, I'll tell you, Randy, I was here at CNN when those drugs came out of the mid-90s, and they were such a miracle. And so everyone thought, well, gee, this means that every patient with HIV is going to get their infection under control. 15 years later, what we're seeing is that that is not really true. And there's a whole lot of reasons for that. And so I'm going to show you, I'm going to break it down for you, why HIV is so not in, under control for so many people. All right, let's take 100 people who are living with HIV. Only 80 are even aware that they have HIV. The other 20 are walking around unaware. Out of those 80, only 62 are linked to HIV care. The others aren't getting care. Out of those 62, only 41 stay in that HIV care. So you see these numbers are getting smaller and smaller. Out of those 41, only 36 are getting the antiretroviral therapy, which is these drugs that we've just been talking about. And then out of that number, only 28 have the virus very low, in very low amounts in their body. So you can see that number just gets smaller and smaller.
It is, which certainly isn't the direction that we want to be going in.
I mean, this is, we were just on the phone with Anthony Fauci at the NIH, and he said, that, you know, this is not good.
Yeah.
This is not a good number.
But this isn't about just protecting and helping the people who are sick. It's about protecting others.
Right. If you do not have that virus under control in your body, that means that you can spread it. And so that's why these drugs are great. If you're taking the drugs and you've suppressed it, that viral load in your body, you're like 95%, you know, the chances that you're not going to transmit it are huge. So you're taking it not just for yourself, but for your sexual partners.
So what about the solution? I mean, how will they end up getting this under control?
Well, you know, one of the, a big part of the solution here is that people need to get tested if you are at all high risk. If you have lots of sexual partners, get tested. If you're a gay or bisexual man, get tested. You know, there's a longer list than that. But if you go to cnn.com/empoweredpatient, we are going to link you up, literally, with places where you can get free HIV testing. That is the first step. That's the first step. If you don't know you have it, you can't get the drugs.
But, I mean, we've been saying that for so long, I feel like. I mean, it's 2011, and there are those who are still living with it and don't know it.
I know, and I think the CDC is trying to do a better job of getting to certain populations. They've come up with a plan, for example, for African-American, gay, and bisexual men, you know, trying to really center in on that population. And, I, you know, they're trying to do a better job of it.
Yeah, well, hopefully it'll work, and they'll get the word out. Elizabeth Cohen, thank you
Thanks.
For the update on that report.